So Jonathan, I'm bored. What's in the email box?
Well, I think we got a bunch of stuff in here. Let's see what we got for myths. So, wow, we got a good one here on vials of all things. Ooh. Customer wants to know what the difference is between different vials. I just think about it as a piece of glass myself, but they want to know if there is a difference and what those would be.
Oh, this is a really good one to check into because there are a lot of different grades of glass out there and different levels of certification for different vials or different polypropylene plates. So this could definitely be worth our time, and I think people will be particularly surprised to see what we find.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see if the vial itself impacts the chromatography.
Let's go.
All right, let's go. Kim, I'm having a hard time trying to believe something as insignificant as a vial can cause problems to chromatography. Look at it, it's just a little vial.
You are gonna be surprised. Let's set up an experiment. And what we can do is look at vials from several different suppliers.
Okay.
And we'll also look at polypropylene just to make it interesting.
All right.
So we can do a couple of different experiments. We can set up one just to look at the interaction of the solvent with the container that it's in. And then we can also set up an experiment where we look at the analytes and see what the impact of the container is.
All right, all right. Maybe there is something to these little vials.
Betcha.
All right. Kim, this has been a really good myth to kind of investigate just because I never really paid that much attention to vials.
It's amazing the impact it can have. So let's look at the data.
All right. So the first test that I did is I just soaked some different vials, different vendors, in pure water and just measured the pH. I would have expected the pH to be the same across all the vials. I wouldn't think there'd be any kind of contribution from the vial. But boy, when you look at the data, you can see that some of these vials significantly increase the pH of the water. And in doing so, if you have analytes that are sensitive or degrade under maybe more alkaline pH conditions, you're gonna cause some problems with your sample. The sample's gonna degrade.
Okay, so Jonathan, we also took a look at the effect of the sample container on two different analytes. And if we look at nortriptyline here, we can see that there's a big difference between the initial injection and then after that, nortriptyline is sat in the vial for about 4 hours. You can see that we've lost quite a bit of signal because that analyte has actually absorbed into the vial.
So it looks like the vial is actually sucking up the analyte.
Yep. Now here we can take a look at gentamicin. This is a paper that we saw at ASMS and we decided to duplicate. And you can see that the initial injection of gentamicin looks pretty good, but that same vial injected 12 hours later, we have lost pretty much all of this sample. We can barely see the gentamicin. So you can see here that that particular vial absorbed nearly all of it.
Wow. And the last experiment we did, Kim, with these polypropylene vials, I think is really compelling. We did a peptide separation, again, in two different polypropylene vials. And you can see from the chromatography on the top vial, we're getting an extra peak.
What is that?
I have no idea. But if you were using the vial in the bottom chromatogram and you were happy with that result, and then you were to switch vials and you got that extra peak, that would trigger you to do some sort of investigation, a lot of extra work. And again, just because of the vial.
That might cause me to lose my weekend and I would not be happy.
Me too. Kim, I totally underestimated these little vials and how they impact chromatography.
I think we saw some pretty vile chromatography out of those little vials.
Yeah, we got to think about these as scientific pieces of glass.
I like that. That's very accurate.
So getting back to the original myth, when it comes to vials, do vials matter? What do you think?
I think they do. So we can tell this scientist that his idea is busted.
Totally busted, totally busted. Vials are an important piece of chromatography, just like the column, just like the system.
Yep.
It's important.
Let's make our reply.
All right.
If you'd like your question to be answered on a future episode, please feel free to email us at trustyourscience@waters.com.